Hi, I'm Greg Hollows, and welcome to the Imaging Lab. We're going to talk about sensor size. You might say to yourself, why is sensor size important instead of optical discussions? But for imaging, it's actually critically important to choose the right sensor and lens combination together to get the desired results. Over the last many years, sensors have come out in a variety of sizes, ranging from anything as small as a 1/6 inch format, which is about 2 millimeters across, up to something as large as 90 millimeters in size. Those are wildly different sizes for sensors. And you can have very adverse impacts on your system if you don't think about that when you're actually putting your system together. Let's take for a second here and try and get an understanding of why this is important. When you image through a lens, you're going to get a round field of view, something like this CD case, the CD that I have here that I just took out of the case. Now, if we have a sensor size that's appropriate for it, like the back of this box, we'll notice as we put the image and the sensor over top of one another, you get sensor coverage all the way around because the image circle is large enough. Now for a second, if I go ahead and take that case that I had before and change my sensor size and it's the same size as that case and I put my image over it, you'll notice that there's black areas of the case actually exposed with this image circle that's here. I won't get full coverage and not maximize what I'm doing for my application or the sensor that I've chosen. One of the big problems that we have out there right now that we need to understand is that there's a variety of resolutions out there. As we add more and more pixels, sensors have a tendency to grow. And that can make it difficult for choosing the right lens. You just can't simply plug one that was on one system into another and expect to get all the desired results. The other thing to understand here too, again, we'll go back to our example. As this sensor size changes, let's say this box is half the size that it is now. We cover it up, turn it this way, and that's our new sensor size. The amount of the image that we're actually covering that was usable has changed. It's going to affect the amount of field of view that we're actually able to be seeing in the system. Critically important. So varying sensors will actually vary the fields of view that we get. If you refer back to some of the other parameters that we've talked about, field of view is one of those critical things that usually ties back to resolution, the amount of object we can see. It's a real disappointment to put a system together and not actually see what we want to get out of the system. Sensor size is usually defined on an imaging system instead of lenses with a maximum sensor coverage that it can handle, usually in a format of a 1/2 inch, 1/3 inch, 2/3 inch, or some physical dimension size. It's important to verify that with the sensor that you're using and understand that the larger the coverage of the lens, it can handle everything that's a smaller size than that in the system. That's sensor size. Next, we're going to talk about a more detailed discussion on resolution and contrast, or you can click any of the links that are most desirable to you.